National Sports University Ordinance 2018. Sir, as repeatedly said in this house during this session, this is the sixth ordinance that this august house is discussing. Here in this case, it is a very strange experience, because the National Sports University Bill was introduced in Lok Sabha on 10th August 2017. And the bill was referred to the Parliamentary Standing Committee on Human Resources Development. And the Standing Committee on HRD has submitted its report on 15th January 2018. I myself is also a member of that Standing Committee. And the Standing Committee has conducted so many evidence has been adduced, detailed discussion took place, and finally the Standing Committee has submitted a very comprehensive report regarding the National Sports University Bill 2017. But what has happened after the submission of the Standing Committee report, it is quite strange to note that after receiving the Standing Committee report on the Bill 2017, an ordinance is promulgated by the government on 31st of May 2018. That is why I am saying that it is a strange experience as far as this ordinance is concerned. When a bill is introduced on 10th August 2017, referred the matter, the bill, to the Standing Committee for close scrutiny of the provisions of the bill, and the Standing Committee on HRD, in its own efforts and hard work, within 6 months or 8 months, after detailed examination of the various provisions of the bill, with recommendations, the committee has submitted the report to the government. After receiving the report, what is the role of the government? When the Standing Committee system has been incorporated in our procedure and rules and procedure, because the recommendations of the Standing Committee has to be taken into consideration by the government, and then the government has to come with proper amendments if they are accepting the recommendations of the Standing Committee. So subsequent to the submission of the Standing Committee report, instead of bringing the bill for consideration passing along with the recommendations of the Standing Committee, you have opted to make the law through the route of ordinance. That is why I am saying that it is really a strange thing as far as this legislation is concerned. Then why you have referred the matter to the Standing Committee? And further more strange is, the rarest of the rare thing has also happened. The new bill, and you have subsequently the bill of 2017, National Sports University Bill of 2017 is subsequently withdrawn in this session, in the monsoon session, they have withdrawn the bill. So the bill which is now pending for discussion or for consideration is the bill of 2018, but there is no substantial change. Only change is, only provision is to repeal the ordinance which have already promulgated on which has already been promulgated. So in such a situation, again the same question arises: why the government is so hurry to issue the ordinance? What was the urgency or what was the exigency in issuing the ordinance? That definitely, once again I want to repeat and reiterate in this house, the parliamentary system of this country is being systematically undermined by the government. This cannot be allowed. Within 2.5 months of time, 6 ordinances were promulgated, and that too for without having any emergency, any necessity, any exigency, no compelling situations, no extraordinary situations. Promulgation of ordinance one by one, one after another, it is not good for a healthy democracy. That is the point which I would like to make, and the parliament cannot be taken for granted, and the parliament is not the stamping authority to stamp all the executive actions of this government. That is not meant for this parliament. So I strongly oppose the ordinance route of legislation, especially in the case of a Standing Committee has already submitted the report, and very, very concrete suggestions have been, recommendations have been made. Instead of incorporating those recommendations, instead of accepting those recommendations and coming with a bill with the proper amendments, government has come with an ordinance before the house. Means that is quite unfortunate as far as the parliamentary ethics is concerned. That is the first point regarding the ordinance which I would like to make. Sir, coming to the bill, I fully support the bill, no doubt about it. I fully support the bill. Sir, National Sports University Ordinance or Bill, it is intended to set up a full-fledged sports university of international standards. We don't have an international status university, we don't have. We are having an existing Lakshmibhai National Institute of Physical Education is there. But there are certain limitations as far as this institute is concerned. They are only, it's a deemed university. But it is restricted in offering bachelor in physical education and master in physical education. And there is no other matters can be considered by that university. And there is another Netaji Subhash National Institute of Sports that is focuses only on training of athletes and coaches. So in order to create a comprehensive sports environment in the country, especially in four areas, as you have mentioned in the statement of objects and reasons, that is in respect of sports science, in respect of sports technology, sports management, sports coaching. These are the four areas where we do not have a proper forum to agitate all these four issues: sports science, sports technology, sports management, and sports coaching. In order to fill this gap, a national university of national university of sports having an international standard with a statutory backing is highly essential, highly required, and I fully support this National Sports University Bill 2017 as well as 2018. Sir, when we consider an university bill, the provisions of the bill has also to be looked into. Sir, it is a full-fledged sports university. Sir, what is mean by a university? That university in the minimum sense, since the time is very limited, I know, I am not going to the details of the university, the provisions of a university. The university in the sense means it should have an autonomous character. It should have an independence. The academic character of the university shall be determined and implemented by their own decisions, their own rules, their own regulations, etc. So university should have the autonomous character. Sir, we are creating a university. Why we are creating a university? It should have independent and autonomous character to develop the academic activities as well as the professional training. Here in this university that is to be established in Manipur, in the Northeast, I fully support that also. Though Kerala is the best place for having this university, according to us, because the experience in athletics, in football, in games, etc. Kerala is the pioneer state in football, pioneer state in the sports and sports activities. Definitely this university ought to have been established in the state of Kerala, but it is in Manipur. I fully expect, fully endorse the view, because it is Northeastern state. Pardon? Sorry, Northeast Manipur, I fully support, because that area should be developed, and also sports person should be developed their area also, so I fully support. And I along with the discussion, I urge upon the Honorable Minister also, Kerala should also be considered as destination of sports university, either the regional center or other center, that should also be given adequate representation, and sufficient importance and significance should be given to the state of Kerala also. So these two are the academic activities have to be improved, as well as the professional training should be given. Sir, otherwise, we need not have a university, because institutes are there. So we are formulating, or we are establishing a university with a specific purpose of creating, providing statutory backing through this legislation, is that to have the autonomous character. But it is quite unfortunate in certain provisions to note that the central government is having absolute authority over this national sports university. So if you examine certain provisions of the bill, the central government is exercising its discretion and authority over the autonomous character of the university. That is the only reservation which I would like to make regarding the contents of the bill, or regarding the contents of this ordinance. So National Sports University shall never be a department under the Ministry of Sports. It shall not be a university for namesake. In almost all cases, here the final authority, if you go through the various chapters of the National Sports University, regarding the curriculum, I'm not talking about the curriculum and syllabus of the university, but regarding the structural organization, as well as the rules and regulations, as well as the inquiry and inspection. In all these cases, if you go through, it is being seen that the central government is absolutely exercising their authority to have the control of the university. Even day-to-day affairs of the government, even day-to-day affairs of the university are being controlled and regulated by the central government means the autonomous character of the university is missing in this bill. That has to be rectified at the earliest. That is the first point which I would like to make regarding the bill. Sir, I can very well substantiate by reading two clauses, clause 7 and clause 25 of the bill. Sir, if you go through clause 7 of the bill, sir, clause 7 of the bill, the unfettered authority cast upon the central government, government of India, is there in clause 7 of the bill. Sub clause 1 of clause 7, the central government may from time to time appoint one or more persons to review the work and progress of the university. Okay, we can very well understand, central government should have the supervision over the university, no doubt I accept. But that is extending, subsequently it is extending to what? Including outlying campuses, colleges, institutions, regional centers and study centers maintained by the university and submit a report to the government of India, and the university shall be abide by such action and be bound to comply with such directions. Sir, kindly see, please see this provision, 7, clause 1. That means two persons will be appointed to supervision, because not only in the university. Suppose you are opening a regional center in Patiala, you are opening a regional center in Kashmir, and under the university, if you are starting some colleges, physical education colleges in various parts of the countries, the government of India personnel can directly go to the college and have the inspection and the inquiry, and they will submit a report, and the university is bound to comply with the directions of the central government. Means what is the university? See, if it is the university, we can very well understand. All the organizations which are institutions and organizations coming under the university shall be inspected and inquired by this supervisory committee, and all the directions of this supervisory committee have to be obliged by the university. Means it is a central government authority. That is why I am saying that the National Sports University shall never be a department coming under the Ministry of the Sports. Sir, again, clause 7, 2 also, I am not going to read. Central government shall have the right to cause an inspection to be made by such persons or persons as may direct the university and buildings. And inspection or inquiry, I have moved so many amendments regarding this. The inquiry has to be deleted. Inspection, it is okay. Government of India can have the, sir, there are Central Vigilance Commission is there. If the university is making, or if the university is violating the statutes and ordinance and directions of the government of India, there are so many other provisions. So if everything is being done by the central government, what is the role of the university? So that has to be central government. If the inspection is made in the university and even outlying campuses also, who shall have the right to present and be heard at the time of inquiry? So I'm not going to the details because of the time. And clause, subclause 9 of clause 7, it is very interesting. Without prejudice to the foregoing provisions of this section, the central government may by order in writing, sir, the central government may by order in writing annul any proceedings of the university which is not conformity with the provisions of the act or statute or ordinance. This is the way the provisions are going. That is why I am making the apprehension. And also clause 25.1, I am not reading. Clause 25.1 is also there. There also the central government is given absolute authority to control the affairs of this university. The concluding word, sir, regarding the sports. Sir, regarding the sports, it is quite pathetic situation of this country. 130 crores of Indian population, we are not even able to have an international standard and international. There is the place of India in international Olympics as well as the football everywhere. If you see, it is a pathetic situation. So the Australian Prime Minister recently visited India and have collaboration with India government to have, they have signed 5 MOUs, and he has spoken in a function, sports build up social capital. Absolutely, it is correct. Sports is a very important component of health management and education. So my suggestion, sir, is sports should be made as a compulsory subject in schools, and Khelo India program, which is initiated by this government to develop sports culture in grassroots level. My point is, identify the sports persons at the grassroots level. If you can identify the sports person at the grassroots level and give international coaching and training and giving nourishments and encouragement, definitely India can develop the sports culture and international sports persons can be built up in this country, for which let this national sports university will be a welcoming step for in such a direction. With these words, I conclude. Thank you very much.
Anurag Thakur.
धन्यवाद उपाध्यक्ष जी. वो समा तैयार करो, वो जहां तैयार करो, लगे मेडलों का अंबार, वो मुकाम तैयार करो. और वो मेडलों का अंबार लगे इसीलिए माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी के नेतृत्व में इस देश में खेलों को आगे बढ़ाने के लिए अलग अलग प्रयास किए गए. और नेशनल स्पोर्ट्स यूनिवर्सिटी बिल एक अपने आप में बहुत अच्छा प्रयास है, जिसके समर्थन में आज मैं बोलने के लिए खड़ा हुआ हूँ. दुनिया भर में अगर आंकलन होता है कि किसी देश